Hey guys, and what's going on? It's Maggie, and I know I haven't posted a video in a while, and I've got a couple reasons to that, but today I wanted to post just a quick short video. First and foremost, I want to apologize. I really had to get this video off of theater mode because while I was playing it, I was not anywhere near my HD PVR. I'm actually doing some rewiring and some revamping. So I had to really get this off of theater mode, and oh god, theater mode is just garbage. So, you know, Infinity Ward for a Christmas present, fix theater mode for me. I will love you forever because, you know, it really helps me out whenever I don't have time to get things done. So today I kind of wanted to talk about the new game type called Drop Zone. Drop Zone was originally an alternate game type, and Infinity Ward decided to put it in a public playlist, and they don't even have a lobby leaderboard for it yet. That's how new it is, and I think it's just here for like a trial basis, just to see how well people like it. But I have to say, I kind of like it. You know, it's not great, but it's not terrible. And in terms of a competitive style playing, definitely not for that. Definitely not. It's just, you know, something fun that if you have a team, you can just go in and just goof around on. Definitely not something that you should probably take seriously. And I did it, and I had a lot of fun with this game. And there's a couple things that I wanted to know. Now, Drop Zone kind of works like Headquarters, where there'll be a specific a key point that you need to hold that turns on, and the Drop Zone is only on for about a minute. So if you've got a minute to collect as much points as possible. Now, when I say points, is that whenever you hold the Drop Zone, you get 20 points per second. Not only does that go to the team score, but it goes towards your personal score as well. Now, each Drop Zone is there, I think I already said this, but it's there for about a minute. So you've got, let's do the math, 60 seconds with 20 points per second. You're going to get 1,200 points in one match. In 1 minute. So that's a lot of time where you can be getting major points in this game. And if you want to rank up fast, this is great. If you want Blast Shield Pro, this is great. And that's another thing I want to talk about, the class setup that you're going to want to use for Drop Zone. So let's go ahead and get into the class setup that I think is the best for Drop Zone. Alright, so the preferred class for Drop Zone, or my favorite class to use while playing the game type Drop Zone, has got to be this class that you're going to see on the screen. Now, your primary weapon is really a weapon that you can use of any choice. You can choose, you know, any SMG, any shotgun, any assault rifle, any LMG. Lots of people like the LMGs now, I wouldn't suggest sniper rifles because you kind of got to get in the action. So any type of primary weapon would work. You know, I just put the Scarl up there because I really like the Scarl. I like how it plays. I enjoy using any type of akimbo machine pistol because I think the machine pistols really have the upper hand in this game. And just because, you know, they're just so powerful. You definitely want to go with some type of grenade. You know, Semtex, frag. I wouldn't suggest throwing knife unless you want to get some pretty cool kill cams or whatever. But definitely go with the nade. And a lot of people don't know this, but the trophy system. Trophy system is great because a lot of people are going to be trying to flash you. They're going to try to EMP you, try to concussion, you know, throwing lots of grenades into the Drop Zone. So if you're thinking of protecting the Drop Zone, if you're going to be in there getting the points, definitely try out the trophy system. It's definitely going to save you one of two times. Two times, but it's definitely going to save you when you get into those close quarters. Now, my first kind of perk that I would suggest you use is Blind Eye. Blind Eye keeps you off the radar from air support. So air support and sentry guns, which people get these in drop packages all the time. So if you want to stay off the radar from the sentry guns or the air support, definitely go and use Blind Eye. That's very, very effective. Blast Shield Pro, it's a must. There's no other second perk that you really need. I love running Hardline, and Hardline's just not going to cut it. So Blast Shield Pro is going to protect you again from those nades. And Steady Aim Pro, just because I, you know, the double akimbo machine pistols, just to give me a little bit of that that firing action, and because your weapon is ready faster after sprinting. So by the time you get to the Drop Zone, you're ready to pop your weapon up and just shoot people down. Your kill streak packages, forget about those, because kill streaks are shut off, and death streaks, we're not even gonna talk about those because I don't even think they should be in the game. Don't worry about any of that stuff. Definitely this is the type of class that you are going to want to run for drop zone. So now let's talk about a little bit of what you can notice from just the HUD of the game. And as you can see here, that in the HUD, you can notice that your... It doesn't label where the next drop zone is. I don't know where they are personally. That would take a lot more playing just to understand where they are. Maybe they're the same as headquarters. But then again, they're not, because all the drop zones have to be outside in order to get the care packages. So that's something cool too, where if you get a package that has a helicopter, you get a package that has a stealth bomber, you're going to be able to use it. You're going to be able to get multiple kills from those, because all the drop zones are located in an outside location. So that's great. Now, if you notice in the top left corner of your screen, there's a bar at the top that says next drop zone. It lets you know how long that drop zone is online for or active for. And also under it says Delta and Spetsnaz, which, you know, depending on what map, it'll say what teams are there. Whether you're, you know, you're in Village and then one of them will say Africa or whatever. But the numbers next to the sides will actually denote how many of your teammates are in the drop zone. And you'll notice that number either increases or decreases depending on how many of your teammates or how many enemies are located in the drop zone. So that's something to think about too, especially when you're grabbing care packages and you're grabbing, you know, like I get a predator in this game and it let me know how many people were next to the drop zone. So if I drop my predator, I knew exactly how many people that it was possible for me to kill, whether it be 4, 5, 2, 1, you know, it'll let you know how many people are there. So that's something great to remember whenever you're playing the game type drop zone. So really the things to remember while playing drop zone: you don't have to play aggressive, but you do have to play it smart. People are spawning everywhere, and you want to get to the drop zone as fast as possible, but you want to secure the drop zone. So it's important to clear the areas, get out of there, and then move straight into the drop zone to control the point. Again, when you pick up the care packages, don't use them mindlessly. If it's some type of air support, like an AH6 Overwatch, use it when the drop zone, when you have like 50 seconds left in the drop zone. Don't use it when you have 10 seconds left in the drop zone, because if all the enemies die in the last 10 seconds, they're going to disappear and you're not going to get as many defense kills with your chopper as you need. Now, I don't say, you know, you don't really need kill streaks because they don't add up to anything, but you do get points for kills, but you really need them to protect the drop zone. So that's something to think about too. Really, I think drop zone is a pretty nice game. And I'll play it with friends, but if I want to really get better and really get those high kill games, drop zone's kind of not the game for that. So if you're just looking for a break, you're just looking to have fun, definitely go out and, you know, play some drop zone. It's definitely interesting. Away from the game now, now that I'm done talking about drop zone, I'll let the game play out. I think I ended like 22-5, but I ended up with more than 3,300 experience points. So that in itself tells you, you know, how many possible points that you can get while playing drop zone. But I kind of want to stray away from the game and give you guys a little bit of heads up about what's going on with me and what's going on with my channel and how things are going down. I'm not leaving YouTube at all. I'm not leaving the gaming circuit at all. I love gaming, you know, I'd always be here near and dear, whatever. But I'm having a lot of trouble with my internet lately. The internet provider that we have is just, it's just shit. It's shit on wheels. So I went out, it's Christmas time, and I went to go look for the best deals, and I found a great deal. A local cable company has offered to come out and give me some really great internet, so that's gonna be coming on Monday. Merry Christmas to me, yay, you know. So maybe my connection will be better on a daily basis rather than, you know, on a hit and miss basis, and everyone can watch Netflix and I can play and we'll all be happy. And I've also got some cool things in the works in terms of, you know, getting videos out. Like in this one, I did some nice color correcting and I did some nice some video things for you guys. But I want to start branching out a little bit, maybe a little bit out of the COD community, but I still want to stay near and dear to my roots with the COD community. So anyways, guys, please like and favorite the video. I'm bringing you a lot more, hopefully on Monday. Thanks, peace.